been a sad, tragic day in Oklahoma history. It is Monday, May 20th, and another deadly tornado has hit Oklahoma. Good evening, I'm Dave Morris for News OK. The state medical examiner is now saying there are 51 confirmed fatalities. Governor Fallon addressed the state earlier today. She says the state is using a number of resources to help with search and rescue efforts, and she's expecting crews from out of state to help with those efforts. According to the Today Show, one of the out-of-state teams is coming from Joplin, Missouri. And you'll remember Joplin was hit with a devastating tornado almost 2 years ago to the day. It happened on May 22nd, 2011. And that was the deadliest tornado in U.S. history with 151 deaths. Governor Fallon says crews are working diligently, quote, trying to look under every piece of debris in every building. We will spare no resources. This is video shot from the Oklahoman's Paul Helstern and aerials by Steve Gooch. State officials have already spoken with FEMA about disaster assistance. The IMSA general manager says they've transported about 100 patients to the hospital. And in fact, OU Medical Center reported as of 7:30 tonight, that facility was treating at least 85 patients, 20 of them adults and 65 of them children. Oklahoma City City Manager Jim Couch was asking residents in the Moore area to use water sparingly and wisely. The Stanley Draper water plant was not hit, but it did lose power. And OG&E officials are working on that. A generator is coming in, and they hope to have it back online by midnight. The Oklahoma Highway Patrol says southbound lanes are now open at I-35 between I-240 and Indian Hills Road. The access roads are still closed, and the off-ramps are also still closed. You're looking at footage from the Oklahoma's Jason Kersey. Officials are saying the damage is similar, if not worse, than what we experienced in May 3rd of 1999. And you'll remember that one. Death toll was at 44. Displaced families can call 405-325-2511 for housing at the University of Oklahoma. Chesapeake Energy is donating $1 million to aid and rescue and recovery efforts in the Moore tornado. And you can find out more information about how you can help. We have a resources page at newsok.com. Again, plenty of video, stories, and photos can be found online tonight at newsok.com as the information continues to come in. Again, the death toll is at 51 and is expected to rise. Stay with News OK for updates and, of course, complete coverage tomorrow in the Oklahoman.